Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, as we offer this Holy Eucharist in honor of St. Anthony of Padua, our patron saint, on this Novena day, let's once again sincerely look into ourselves and see where we have faltered and failed, and let us ask the Lord pardon and forgiveness for all our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who gave St. Anthony of Padua to your people as an outstanding preacher and intercessor in their need, grant that with his assistance, as we follow the teachings of the Christian life, we may know your help in every trial. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Please turn to page number 325 from the Old Testament. Page 325. A reading from the first book of Kings, chapter 18, verse 20 to 39. Chapter 18, verse 20 to 39. Elijah's triumph over the priests of Baal. So Ahab sent to all the Israelites and assembled the prophets at Mount Carmel. Elijah then came near to the people and said, "How long will you go limping with two different opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him." The people did not answer him a word. Then Elijah said to the people, "I only am left a prophet of the Lord. But Baal's prophets number 450. Let two bulls be given to us. Let them choose one bull for themselves, cut it in pieces, and lay it on the wood, but put no fire to it. I will prepare the other bull and lay it on the wood, but put no fire to it. Then you call on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord. The God who answers by fire is indeed God." All the people answered, "Well spoken." Then Elijah said to the prophets of Baal, "Choose for yourselves one bull and prepare it first, for you are many. Then call on the name of your God, but put no fire to it." So they took the bull that was given to them and prepared it and called on the name of Baal from morning until noon, crying, "O Baal, answer us." But there was no voice and no answer. They limped about the altar that they had made. At noon, Elijah mocked them, saying, cry aloud, "Surely he is a god, either he is meditating or he has wandered away, or he is on a journey, or perhaps he is asleep and must be awakened." Then they cried out aloud, and as was their custom, they cut themselves with swords and lances until the blood gushed out over them. As midday passed, they raved on until the time of the offering of the oblation. But there was no voice, no answer, and no response. Then Elijah said to all the people, "Come closer to me." And all people came closer to him. First, he repaired the altar of the Lord that had been thrown down. Elijah took 12 stones according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the word of the Lord came, saying, "Israel shall be your name." With the stones he built an altar in the name of the Lord. Then he made a trench around the altar, large enough to contain 2 measures of seed. Next, he put the wood in order, cut the bull in pieces, and laid it on the wood. He said, "Fill 4 jars with water and pour it on the burnt offering and on the wood." Then he said, "Do it a second time." And they did it a second time. Again he said, "Do it a third time." And they did it a third time, so that the water ran all around the altar and filled the trench also with water. At the time of the offering of the oblation, the prophet Elijah came near and said, "O Lord, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, that I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at your bidding. Answer me, O Lord, answer me, so that this people may know that you, O Lord, are God, and that you have turned their heart back." Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering, the wood, the stone, and the dust, and even licked up the water that was in the trench. When all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and said, "The Lord indeed is God. The Lord indeed is God." The word of the Lord. Kindly turn to page number 581 from the book of Psalm. Page 581. Psalm number 16, verse 1 and 2, 4 and 5, and 8 and 11. Psalm number 16, our response shall be, "The Lord our God is holy." Psalm number 16, verse 1 and 2. "Protect me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, you are my Lord. I have no good apart from you." Psalm 4 and 5. "Those who choose another God multiply their sorrows. Their drink offering of blood I will not pour out, or take their names upon my lips. The Lord is my chosen portion and my cup. You hold my Lord." Verse 8. "I keep the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand. I shall not be moved." Verse 11. "You show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. In your right hand are pleasures forevermore." Our response, the Lord our God is holy. Kindly stand for the gospel acclamation.
We sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, praising His name, praising His name. We sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, praising His
name. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Chapter 5, verses 17 to 19, and page 4. Chapter 5, verses 17 to 19. Jesus said, "Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches them will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May the words of the Gospel wipe away our sins. As human beings, we always look for sensational things. And that's the reason why when we see a great statue, horrifying, and great decorations, all that, no, we are attracted by them. So also, even as Catholics, we are attracted by sensational things. If the statue of the one of the saints, the eyes are open in the statue, what happens? Everybody will flock to there. Because we want to see something is happening there. But what is important for us is, we need to ask the Lord to open our spiritual eyes so that we will be able to experience the presence of the Lord every moment of our life. That is more important for us. So also the people of Israel were carried away by all kinds of worships, by Baal, which was encouraged by King Ahab and his wife Jezebel. Instead of worshipping the Lord God, the God of Israel, God of Abraham and God of Isaac, they started worshipping all the Baal gods. In order to bring them to their senses and prove to them
that the Lord God is God alone. He is the only God. Elijah made the people to face a challenge on Mount Carmel, where they were asked to offer a sacrifice by the priests of the Baal, and he said he himself will offer a sacrifice. A God who answers by fire and burns the offering will be the true God. The prophets and the priests of Baal prepared the sacrifice. They went on crying till midday, even cutting their flesh, bleeding, oozing out. Nothing has happened. Then when Elijah prepared the offering, prayed to the Lord God Almighty, the Lord answered him by sending the fire upon the offering and burning it. And then only people acknowledged, saying that the Lord God is God alone. What we need to understand, through this is, what is important for us is that prayer in spirit. Pray in the Holy Spirit. That's what the Word of God encourages us. It may not be appealing to us, sensational to us, but the fruits of our prayer, praying in the Spirit, will be manifested in our day-to-day life. Especially sitting in the adoration chapel, you only see with your human eyes the bread. But as with our faith, eyes of faith, we see the very presence of Jesus in the Holy Eucharist. And when we spend time in worshipping Him and adoring Him, surely we will be filled with the presence of God, and the presence of God will go with us wherever we go, and the presence of God will give us every prosperity, every protection, and every success. So also when we participate in the Holy Eucharist, we are offering the bread and wine. And in the Holy Eucharist, the bread and wine are transformed into the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. And with faith we receive the Holy Communion, preparing ourselves worthily so that we may be filled with the presence of God. Because Jesus Himself promised us, if you eat My body and drink My blood, I will be in you and you will be in Me. Gospel of John, chapter 6, verses 56 and 57. Let's always give importance to the presence of God rather than all the sensational things. And the presence of God will enrich us in every way. In every situation, will help us to overcome, and we will really live a fruitful and successful life. In the Gospel today, Jesus tells us He has come to fulfill the law. That's why Jesus tells us that in the Old Testament, you said, love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But Jesus fulfills the law saying, love your neighbor and pray for your enemies. And this is how Jesus fulfilled the law. We need to understand the teaching of Jesus and follow the teaching of Jesus by observing it. Then surely we will have life and life in all its fullness. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we celebrate the feast of St. Anthony, we pray, O Lord, that you may pour out your blessing from heaven on these offerings we have made to you, so that in partaking of them we may be without fault and be replenished with heavenly food. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Anthony you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed, and he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Bala our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Xavier Robert, J.D. Anthony, Jepamani, whom you have called from this world to yourself, Grant that they who are united with your Son in death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially all those who have died in our own families and in our parish, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Anthony, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Those who are celebrating their birthdays can come forward to receive the communion.
Thank you.
Let us take the prayer for the Jubilee Year of Mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, you have taught us to be merciful like the Heavenly Father, and have told us that whoever sees you sees him. Show us your face and we will be saved. Your loving gaze freed Zacchaeus and Matthew from being enslaved by money, and the adulteress and Magdalene from seeking happiness only in created things, made Peter weep after his betrayal, and assured paradise to the repentant thief. Let us hear, as if addressed to each one of us, that word that you spoke to the Samaritan woman, if you knew the gift of God. You are the visible face of the invisible Father, of the God who manifests his power above all by forgiveness and mercy. Let the church be your visible face in the world, glorified. You will that your ministers would also be clothed in weakness, in order that they may feel compassion for those in ignorance and error. Let everyone who approaches them feel sought after, loved and forgiven by God. Send your Spirit and consecrate every one of us with its anointing, so that the Jubilee of Mercy may be a year of grace from the Lord, and your church, with renewed enthusiasm, may bring good news to the poor, proclaim liberty to captives and oppressed, and restore sight to the blind. We ask this through the intercession of Mary, Mother of Mercy, you who live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Through Christ the Teacher, O Lord, instruct those you feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast day of St. Anthony they may learn your truth and express it in works of charity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.